गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ अजीत प्रताप सिंह. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो ऑफ क्लास 8th साइंस आई विल टेल यू अबाउट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, अपार्ट फ्रॉम माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स इंट्रोडक्शन, आई विल लेट यू नो अबाउट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, हाउ वी कैन ऑब्जर्व माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. ओके, अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस आई विल लेट यू नो हाउ वी कैन सी microorganisms and I'll also talk about where are microbes found, and also I'll let you know about what are the types of microorganisms. Okay students, so let's start with the microorganisms. Okay students, as we all know that the name is suggesting that organisms which are very small in size and which cannot be seen from the naked eyes, these are known as microorganisms. Okay, and these microorganisms can be observed with the help of following activity, that is activity number 1, to observe microorganisms. Okay students, for this first of all we have to take a drop of pond water and we have to look at it carefully. Will we able to see the living organisms in it? No, because these are very small. Okay, now what we will do, now we will put this drop of water on a glass slide which is made up of glass and which is circular in shape. Okay, and then we will examine it under a light microscope. Now can you see the tiny structures called organisms floating or moving about swiftly or very quickly? Yes, now we will be able to see them. As you can see in this picture that whenever we see a drop of pond water with the help of microscope, then we will see the microbes moving very quickly or very swiftly, like this in the figure 2.1b part. Okay, and this is how we can observe the occurrence of microbes with the help of microscope. Okay students, now we move to the next slide. In this activity, as I told you, it has been shown that organisms live in water as well, in soil also, and even inside our body. So not only organisms live in water, they are also found in soil as well as in our body. And because they are very small in shape and size, that's why we are not able to see them with the help of our naked eyes. So this is very much true. Okay students, so because they cannot be seen with the help of naked eyes, that's why they are also known as microorganisms or microbes. So in short, we can say that organisms that are very small and that can only be seen with the help of a microscope are known as microorganisms or microbes. Okay, these organisms have a great impact on humans in many ways, because some of them causes a lot of diseases, while some of them are able to cure them as well. So some provide us with food as well as some can spoil the food as well. So we can say that some of the microorganisms are beneficial and some of the microorganisms are harmful. So the study of microorganisms is also known as microbiology, and the scientists who study microorganisms are also known as microbiologists. Okay, now I'll show you the shape of the bacteria, although we'll discuss in detail about bacteria in the next video, that is cocci, wesley and spirilla. These are different type of bacteria. Okay, Now we will talk about where are microbes or microorganisms are found. Okay, as we all know that microorganisms are hardly and can be found in almost any kind of environment. So we can say they are present everywhere because they can survive in almost every kind of environment. They are found in the hottest of deserts also. And on the other hand, they are found in the coolest icy polar regions also. So they are able to survive, as I told you, in the hottest conditions also, and they are able to survive in the coolest conditions also of polar regions. Some microbes live in cracks in the sea floor, while some of the microorganisms can even survive a volcanic eruption as well. Microorganisms or microbes are found in salt water also, in marshland also, and also even inside our body. So they are found almost everywhere, in the salty water, in the marshland, and also inside our body. Microorganisms are very hard because they form a hard outer covering called a cyst around themselves. And they do this when conditions are not favorable. So they use it as their favor when the conditions are not favorable to them, such as under extreme conditions of temperature and dryness. So they use it in the extreme conditions of temperature and dryness. So they survive by remaining inactive within the cyst until conditions are favorable again. Okay, students, when the conditions are favorable again. Now we will talk about the types of microorganisms. Okay, students, there are five major groups of microorganisms. These are as follows. First one is known as bacteria. In singular, we call it them as the bacterium also. The second one is algae. That is known as alga also. And the third one is known as protozoa. That is known as protozoan also. And now the next slide. These are fungi. In singular, we call it them as the fungus. And at last, these are viruses. And in singular, we call it them the virus. So these are the types of microorganisms which are found, as I told you, in the atmosphere or in the environment. And as I told you, students, they are able to survive in any condition. So now I would like to recap the whole video which I have told you so far about microorganisms. We can say that microorganisms are the living organisms which are found around us, and because they are very very small in shape and size, that's why we are not able to see them with our naked eyes. Okay, students. And also I told you about, with the help of microscope, we are able to see them only, whatever we want to see about them. Okay, and they are found in soil as well as in water. Okay, and also in our body. So they are found almost everywhere. Okay, and the study of microorganisms is known as microbiology, and the scientists who study microorganisms are known as microbiologists. Okay, and I also told you about where are they found. Microbes are found almost everywhere. They are found in the hottest regions also, and they are found in the coolest regions of the world also, like polar regions. So these are the occurrence of microorganisms. So that's it in this video.